All right now, for all you tepid takers out there in the big city, all you street people with an ear for the action, I've been asked to relay a request for the Tepid Take. It's a special for all you listeners all over the globe. Here's a banger of an episode with you in mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, I finally got my way. We're going to talk about car stuff. We're going to talk about car games. We're going to talk about driving games. I've been wanting to talk about cars.
Excited, every single one of us.
Addison loves racing games. He absolutely adores them.
That's so
He's
good.
Done it as his Mini as well, haven't you?
Yeah, sure. Something like that.
Hello and welcome to the Tepid Take again.
Thanks for having me.
I don't know what that was, but I just thought I'd add it in.
You do.
In case people didn't know, they just clicked on Tepid Take and gone.
Yeah. They might have done that, like had it on shuffle on Spotify or something. Can you do that on podcasts? You probably
I don't
can.
Know. Can you do that?
You should be able to.
No idea, to be honest.
If we've been shuffled into your playlist right now, let us know.
Yeah, I don't listen to podcasts. I'm not a fucking nerd.
And you just alienated
What's your favourite podcast,
listeners?
Addison?
This one.
Wee.
So, today we're going to talk about some cool stuff. We're all talking about games as well. It's just a game one.
It is a very gamey.
There's no like TV or film. Don't want to know today.
No.
Yeah,
it did take us 20 episodes to get to a point where we talked all games.
Yeah.
I'm quite impressed.
It had to be one I hosted
that's
as well.
Crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, always do games, so.
I do always do games. I didn't do it last time. I did a film.
Because we called you out for always doing games.
Yeah. I watched a fucking film.
I had to sit down for an hour and a half and watch fucking film.
Weren't you originally going to do a short film as well, like 30 minutes?
Yeah, I didn't know it was 30 minutes when I said I was going to do it, though, to be fair.
Did you just like hold a controller in your hand while you're watching?
Pretend, yeah. Make pretend it's like one of those super massive games where you're quick time events. Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Jack Nicholson's going to chop me with an axe if I don't press X.
Hold down one and R1 at the same time. Quick.
Talking about games, we're going to talk about Metal Gear Solid 1. We're going to talk about Mario Party Superstars on the new Mario Party game. I fucked that one up completely. You know what I'm talking about.
Stay in.
Resident Evil 4 in VR and Ring Fit Adventure. We're going to start off with talking about Metal Gear Solid. So, Addison, take us away.
Oh, what's this game about? So I've decided to play through the Metal Gear Solid series. I was originally going to play through all of them and then discuss them on the podcast, but I had some strong opinions on the first one.
Did you get a sour taste in your mouth?
Yeah, a little bit. This game's fucking old, isn't it?
When did it come out, though? Is it 98?
It is pretty aged, I will say that.
Yeah.
I feel like every time we talk about Metal Gear Solid and we're actually talking about it, it's always negative.
It's like, this game is so...
Because you spoke about 3, didn't you? Mm. On one of our earlier podcasts.
I did, yeah. It was pretty negative.
So far, I have completed the first one, and I'm halfway through 2, hoping to complete it if the news that came out today that it's being delisted doesn't actually affect me or not. Not sure at the
moment.
So
it's a copyright problem, isn't it? The copyright's probably run out or something.
Sounds like it, with the old sort of footage they use, I think it is.
Probably the lights
2 and 3.
Which
is very irritating because I've been playing them online through PS Now, and if I don't get to complete it, I'm going to be very irritated and probably never go back to it. If I'm honest. Now, Sam, we know you love this game, but...
It's fine.
You gotta admit, it's fucking dated, right?
It is, yeah. I think... Because I think, obviously, I played it like when it came out and kind of grew up playing it, so I think I still have like the muscle memory going back and playing it.
Yeah.
But I can imagine
I really don't. So, yeah. Just a quick history of my experience with Metal Gear Solid is I have basically none. I've played Metal Gear Solid 5 when it came out, And I remember when it was coming out, I think I even messaged you saying, what the fuck is going on? Can you send me a link to a video so I understand what the hell is happening?
I was like, that video does not exist.
And
Sam, make
one. I found one and went, nah, this makes no sense.
Yeah.
No point.
Yeah. Like, why does every character have 10 different names?
I've played 1 to 5 and I still don't know what the fuck is going on. I have no idea where I am
at the moment. I feel like I have a handle on it, and I am expecting it to all like go sideways.
It's all right until after 3 or after 4, and then they sort of go, "Oh, let's do loads of fucking comics and PSP shit." And you're like, "What the fuck is going on?"
You need that. You need the Japanese game with the fucking peripherals that you can only play on if you've got them.
It's definitely dated.
Yeah, my main issues, aside from the controls, which were just so janky, was what it was making you do annoyed me. Because it sends you back and forth a lot for no particular reason.
Yeah.
The one that really stuck in my head was the PAL cards?
Yeah.
I can't remember that. I think I blocked it.
You get to
a
location that's like the furthest in the game that you can actually go. Like, it's like the furthest point from the beginning that you can walk to.
Yeah.
And you have to put a card in, then trek all the way back to one place to change that card doing something in the game. I won't spoil it just in case anyone wants to play it.
Oh, okay, yeah.
That's the general gist. Take it back to that place, take it even further than that first place, and then go all the way back. And it was just so unnecessarily complicated. And all it's doing is giving you time to, like, on the lift, have a little conversation with some more people to wrap up a few things, and I'm pretty sure that's the only reason they did it like that.
Yeah, it could be actually. Yeah, because it's funny because in the comic, it's funny how they get around that. Because when I was reading it, I was like, how the hell are they going to do that? Are they literally going to make, you know, Snake go back in the comic? But literally, the room that you get to in the comic, there's like 2 pipes.
Okay.
And so, without spoiling it.
Yeah. That makes more sense.
And I was like,
and would work in the game, I guess.
Yeah.
Or at least have them in the same room, like, or in the same area. But making you go all the way back for no other reason than to do this was just irritating.
Yeah.
And the boss fights were horrendous. Yeah, I had real problems with, in particular, the sniper really fucked me off.
Yeah. Was it because you fight it twice, don't you, Sniper Wolf?
Yeah, and I kind of did the first one properly, but she just has like fucking supervision, and then by the second one,
a sniper.
I had, but it's ridiculous. But by the second one, I didn't have any of those pills that you needed, and I couldn't be fucked to go back and find any.
Oh my god!
And whenever I tried to aim at her, like, I try and look for her, and the way it makes you kind of go down and then into first person view is a very long process, and by the time you've done that, she's already shot me and knocked me out of first person view, and it was just so irritating. So I had to cheese it by hiding in the corner and sending rockets that you could direct
to her. Oh, the Nikita ones.
Yeah, and that, I just killed her using that. I had so many of those bombs, it was like, it was fine.
Yeah, I remember once, because when you complete the game, you get some like unlockables. And I think the way that you complete it, you get a bandana, which gives you like infinite ammo whenever you're wearing it.
Yeah, I think I did unlock that in the end. I think it told me that.
And I remember on my second playthrough, I was wearing it with the stinger and just doing something, just like targeting her with the stinger and just blowing her up. And I was like, oh my god, it's so much fucking easier.
Yeah, it was. This is a game that was designed for when people would have one game and that's all they would play.
Yeah,
because the stuff you need to work out is a bit, it's a bit Dark Souls-y in that way. Like the way your brain is meant to work isn't how people's brain works. I don't think so anyway.
Yeah.
So it's trying to make you do stuff, and you're like, how the fuck am I meant to know that without looking it up?
Yeah.
So whilst it sounds like I'm absolutely ragging on this game, I did kind of enjoy it, but I am so glad it's over, and I will never touch this fucking thing again.
I really want you to play more 90s games, because this is how most of them are.
Yeah, especially the PlayStation era. They have aged the worst.
Like. Yeah, well, I do this often. Like, there'll be a classic franchise that's just I just want to play through it, and I've always heard about it and just never got around to doing. Like, I did it with God of War. I played through all of those. I did it with Resident Evil as well. And now I'm kind of doing it with this. And this is the one I've had the most trouble with. Like, definitely. It was just that first game. And I'm halfway through two. Around about halfway, I think. Yeah. I'm really enjoying it. Controls are updated enough that I'm getting on with it a lot better. There's still that weird logic to things where I'm like, how am I meant to know where that stuff is? But I feel like it's a little bit easier to figure out what you're doing.
Okay,
just because of the way it's laid out. So I am getting on. The main character's fucking annoying, but whatever.
Yeah. Right in for.
Yeah. And it does have the best intro music ever.
Oh, yes.
If you've got it, Matt.
Oh, that's so fucking...
Just good. Every time I load it up, I'm just like, yeah. I'm ready to do some spy shit.
I'm ready to do just leave the menu shit on.
I know. That's I always forget good. Until I play it again. I'm like, oh, this menu music's so fucking...
It's just cool, yeah.
Yeah.
So I am enjoying it, like, despite, because I was texting the guys whilst I was playing this first game, absolutely ragging on it every second.
There were a lot of every time, the comments.
Yeah, every time I got to a point where I was stuck, I was like, fuck, this game, it is so shit. And I stand by that.
What do you think about, like, the, like, story and characters? What's your kind of take on that?
I'm actually quite enjoying it because it's so B-movie-esque, which I love B-movies, and it's clearly not taking itself very seriously. I feel like the second one's going for a bit grander themes and metaphors maybe, but you mentioned something earlier that I haven't quite got to, so I'm interested to see how that kind of ties in.
I can't wait for you to get to the end of that game, actually. I can't wait to see the comments come through on WhatsApp.
I'm enjoying something. I feel like the game may be fucking with me, and I may have said something that might be incorrect. But we'll talk about it another time. Maybe when I've completed the games, we can do like a bit of a spoiler.
Yeah.
I have a real problem remembering the games. I just have a real problem remembering Metal Gear Solid games. I really don't know why. I kind of like, I go back to them every now and then, and I go, oh yeah, that happened.
I forgot about this.
Yeah,
I'm not sure. I'd
say fair enough, Matt, but it's you. You're so bad at remembering stuff.
These are worse. It's not normally this bad.
I'm kind of surprised by that because it, like, obviously I've only been playing it like over the last 2 weeks, I guess. On and off, and it's definitely stuck in my head. But maybe that's because I was so frustrated by that first one, and I'm obviously still playing the second one. So
yeah. I've played them a huge gap in between them all, I think.
Yeah, and maybe ask me in a year, and I'll be like, I don't even know what happened in the second one.
No, I don't think you will.
Do you ever find that with, like, big bosses, that the harder they are, the more you remember the game you played?
Big boss.
Yeah.
Sorry, that was a Metal Gear.
Metal Gear reference. I get that reference.
Really?
We referenced this in so many podcasts now, and finally we reviewed it.
Yeah. What was I going to ask? Oh, yeah, how are you finding the... Because I've been playing the second one at the moment as well. And I fucking forgot. Like with the second one especially, the amount of cutscenes is genuinely... Like, there's a lot in the second one I found.
I think it affected me more in the first one. One, because it was annoying me.
A lot
playing through. And also because the graphics are so bad that they're kind of having these conversations. And you're just like, this is just hilarious.
Like Lego blocks
and I also
talking to each other.
I wasn't expecting them to be long in that one.
Yeah, so you
because
like
I knew he did this, but I thought it was like a later on thing. I wasn't expecting it to happen in the first game. So by the time I got to the second one, I was kind of expecting it. The graphics were a lot better. I'm now expecting these long ass cutscenes where I can just put my controller down, kick back
a
little
bit,
and just be like, I'll be like okay to like move on. Although the ones that are annoying me are the when you try and save. They then have a conversation.
Which is very irritating.
Especially the Raiden and Rose ones are fucking... Those
ones specifically. I'm guessing it happened in the first one as well. But because I was playing it on PC through Steam or GOG or whatever, you save slightly differently. So you didn't have to do that.
No, that's true. Yeah, you're right. Yeah,
like a save state, I think, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. In the first one, you have Mei Ling, and she gives you some, like... weird quote, and then you had a conversation about that. The third one's pretty good. I think you'll like it because they talk about films, and it's like, oh, they talk about Godzilla and stuff, and like King Kong.
Love it.
Get out of here, Matt. Get out of here.
I am fully expecting to play that game and like have it be my favourite.
I'm expecting that as well.
Matt hates it so much.
Yeah.
You just know it's going to happen.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just five.
The game
long story,
is.
But
yeah.
I love the zombie one. It's the best.
The zombie one. Let me survive.
Oh, God. Without your gun.
Maybe we'll talk about this a bit more in depth. I think I've taken enough of your time on this one. So, should we move on?
Yeah, so talking about old games or older games, I've been playing a technically a new game, but it is of an old game.
Yeah.
Game.
That was like trying to get a word count in an essay, that.
I'm so lost, and I know what you've been playing, and I'm still like, what?
So I've been playing Resident Evil 4 in VR, because it just recently got released on the Oculus Quest 2, exclusively. And
oh, wow.
Yes. Wow. And, yeah, I mean, it kind of, like, is amazing, but I've done a little, like, edit for you guys to sort of watch / listen to. And
Sean Connery.
Obviously, if everyone listening, it's fairly self-explanatory what the hell's going on. But this is an edit of me responding to shit going down in Resident Evil 4. So this is the whole game, basically, in like 2.5 minutes.
Oh my God.
Fucking hell! It's huge!
Nice little time in there, little village.
Oh, fuck me! How are you getting all this fucking axes from? You okay? You good? Oh my God, run! Oh! I'm gonna play with your skulls! Ooh! Have you got a fucking dynamite in your hand? Oh my God! Oh, this is cool! Oh no, it's Big John! Oh, you little shitbag! Why are you in the loo? No, fuck you! What the fuck is this? Oh, fucking snake! Oh, a snake! Fuck you, snake!
That was the last game, wasn't it?
Get dual bitches! Yeah. Oh, I thought it was a fucking snake. It's a fucking plant. Troll in the dungeon! Oh, no, no! What the fuck? Big John's bigger! What the fuck?
Did you not play this before?
No, I haven't played this.
No.
She got squished! What am I supposed to do? Oh fuck! It's fucking invisible! It's what so the weird. Fuck like, is that? Yeah. Fucking prompt! Yeah. Fucking prompt!
Prompts?
Oh, fucking prompt!
I don't remember
the fuck is this Skyrim? Yeah, come on. Yeah, fucking, you're alive, aren't you? I can see you're fucking alive. Like that was a fucking surprise. My hands run out of battery. Oh, I didn't think he'd come after me. Fuck, he's coming after me. Oh, fucking hell. How is the scariest thing in this? A fucking man in the corner. You know, I'm checking every corner, man. Little fuck bag. Oh, don't be a dickhead. Oh my God, now there's fucking robots. What is this? What the fuck? Oh, you
so many
fucking
enemies in this game I just forgot about.
Bitch. Excuse you? Oh fuck, I almost walked off that. Oh, how the fuck do you block that? Oh, he jumped on my head. Oh my God. I'm driving a fucking jet ski. Whoa, this is a bit weird. This is truly the best game I've ever played. Holy fucking shit. Oh, shit.
Road Jeremy likes to drive the whole place.
I was going to say, your Norfolk was coming out in that clip. Yeah. Can I just say, I love how Ashley wasn't in that. I appreciate you for not playing her in
that. Do you know, she wasn't actually that bad in the VR version of it. I didn't find that she was awful. What did you hate about her in that game?
The repeated voice clips, just how
constant
and loud it was.
Leon!
Yeah.
Help! She wasn't too bad in VR. I feel like she didn't get as captured as much, perhaps.
Maybe I was just worse at the game than you.
Well, it's a different way of playing it, isn't it? This is totally different. But this
seems so much fun.
Yeah,
that is literally probably the best VR game I've ever played. It was awesome. It was a phenomenal game. I'm so impressed by it.
This isn't a matism.
No, this is not a matism. I'm, you know, you can probably tell from my reaction to it, like, just so much of the shit I was just so surprised by. I'm so glad I never played it before, though. Because it really added to the atmosphere, and it added to, like, my surprise on these stupid things. That fucking, what's it, Krauser, when he fucking hides, I did not expect him to hide around a fucking corner. It shit me up. I had to, like, kneel for a bit after
was
that.
Was that the guy with the knife?
Yeah, that's the guy with the knife, yeah. The guy who's chasing you,
yeah.
But that's actually quite terrifying in VR.
So what's it's a good game.
Yeah.
Because I was spot on a couple of things.
yeah.
Is that your, like, there was, like, what I thought it was first was, like, an audio waveform, but is that your health? Is that, like, the heart monitor?
Yeah, so that's the, when you get damaged, I think, isn't it? Yeah.
Right, yeah.
But that comes across the screen or comes across your eyes. And okay. Yeah, but you've got a watch as well, which I don't think you probably saw on there, but there's a watch that's got all, you've got your money on there and your health, and Ashley's health on your watch that's as cool. well, so it's all, like, accessible. And then on your chest, you've got a knife, and you've got a grenade on your chest as well. You've got a pistol or what, your one-handed weapon on your right hip, or your left hip if you're left-handed, I suppose. And then you've got a rifle, two-handed weapon on your back.
That's really cool. So it plays just, like, totally differently.
It plays like a VR game. And health on your shoulder as well. But
the VR game plays like a VR game.
It does. I'm going to, like, VR games, like Skyrim in VR is nowhere near as immersive as that. You have to do menus and shit still. And it kind of takes you out of the game. Whereas this, everything is kind of there. Obviously, you've got to go in the menu because you've got to do, like, big thing about Resident Evil is fucking inventory management.
Yeah, yeah.
It's still there, but, you know, it's not as bad as you could imagine. Like, it's not as bad as Skyrim, where it's, like, almost infinite.
That's just
awful. That's not great in VR. But, I mean, yeah, so... it's, like I say, it's so immersive in VR. They've really, like... It feels like they've made a fresh game in VR.
Yeah,
it really suits Resident Evil 4 as well. I think it's perfectly
definitely looks like the graphics wouldn't have been, like, much of a problem either.
No, because it's on the Quest 2, you don't expect that great graphics anyway unless you plug it into a PC. Yeah. But it's native Quest, so you can play it without wires. You could just play it with a headset.
That's
cool.
That's cool.
Wow. And, like, graphics, they actually look pretty decent. I can't say I ever really thought, oh, this looks shit. It actually looks good. Like, if you look at, like, water, it actually looks pretty decent. Probably better than, you know, it does in the actual Resident Evil 4 game.
Yeah.
I can't put into words how awesome this game actually is in VR. It's so good. The puzzles, cool. you saw a bit of the puzzles in there, but you wouldn't have heard it. But, like, the puzzles, they are actually, like, physical. So you actually physically do the puzzles. There's one with a crystal ball and a door. So you've got to, like, move the crystal ball and the door, like, physically. And then there's, like, another one where you've got a, you know, it's one of those puzzles where you trade, like, pieces, and it, like, it's like squares, isn't it? There's, like, nine squares.
I remember that puzzle.
Yeah, and you slide the squares so they eventually fall into place. It took me fucking ages. It takes so long, yeah.
But, like, it'd be easy with my hands.
Yeah, well, yeah, it's kind of, yeah. But, for that purpose alone, it's just so immersive. I felt like I was actually, like, in Resident Evil 4, you know. It's really good. Obviously,
we can tell by the quips you were telling.
Yeah.
Is that how you play games generally?
Obviously, I, like, you know, camp it up a bit, but...
camp it up. I think you're playing it down, I know you were.
No, I just love the idea of you, to be honest, your neighbours hearing this.
Yeah, I actually with VR games.
God, it's massive.
What are you doing around the corner?
Yeah. Fucking hell! Oh, the amount of swearing.
Oh, Big John.
Big John.
Big John.
He's bigger.
Oh, yeah, that's one thing I want to ask. There's that boss battle where it's like a massive... Is it a massive fish or something? Yeah.
I didn't actually put that in there. VR? Yeah, that was pretty fucking awesome. You saw a bit in that. There's footage of me in a jet ski and it kind of plays a bit like that,
right?
Where you're in a boat, so you don't actually use, like, the actual, like, I don't know what it's called, like the rudder, I guess, on a boat.
Yeah.
or the motor. You use the analog stick, but it's quite immersive because you're actually like still shooting the harpoon with your hand, and you're reloading it with your hands. So,
Or you like throw it like the harpoon.
I imagine if you get motion sick, that's probably going to do it.
Yeah.
No, you launch it with a harpoon gun. What's he do in the game? Okay. Does he not do that in the game?
I feel like he throws it like a spear.
Oh, yeah, I wish I'd done like that. That'd be amazing.
Yeah.
But no, they do it as a harpoon gun in this game.
Yeah, I can see why.
Yeah.
Like, easier workaround.
Yeah, so, I'm just like overwhelmed by how awesome it was. I was when I finished it, I was kind of gutted because it was like so good. It was obviously long. It was like 11 and a half hours long, but it was such a good experience, and I'm so glad that I've played it for the first time in VR. So if you've never played Resident Evil 4 before, I totally recommend playing it in VR because it's like just experiencing it in a whole new set of eyes. It's probably now my favorite Resident Evil. For that reason. Yeah.
It is a good one.
I know why people have... A lot of people say that's their favourite, but, you know, because it's so action-y, it really works in VR. Like, really works. Yeah. I know that I think there's a week ago, people have started doing videos on people doing a Resident Evil 2 mod in VR, and I think that would be fucking great.
Yeah.
Fucking incredible. Yeah. So I hope... From this, I kind of hope that... more games take it up, because I know they're going to do GTA San Andreas in Oculus Quest, aren't they?
Yeah.
Which is fine, but you know, that's just like a shooting and driving game. It's not like
going
like
to Resident Evil. Fucking train, yeah. Jesus Christ! I'm not
You got. I wonder if you got like cycle. How would
CJ.
You cycle? Yeah. But I want to see. Do you know what I would like to see is actually MGS in VR. I think that would be superb.
Fucking hell, that'd be cool.
Yeah. I don't know how they'd do it, but. That'd be awesome.
I can see that.
Okay, yeah. I'll never do it.
No. Well, hopefully, I still this can't has opened the door.
Resi Evil 4 was a GameCube exclusive.
I know.
It was, wasn't it? Yeah, to begin with. It took a few years before it. I think it came to PS2 eventually, but it was like quite a few years. Yeah, they had like the license for a while because they had the Resident Evil remake and then they did Resident Evil 0 as well on the GameCube.
They also had Metal Gear Solid Twin Snakes on the GameCube, didn't they?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's the remake of one.
I wish I recommended that to Addison instead.
Yeah.
I don't think I have a way of playing it. That's a remaster of the first one, right?
Emulation.
It pretty much plays like MGS 2.
I had no idea what Matt said.
You're saying emulation.
Yeah.
Because Nintendo.
I cannot give it more praise. You know, it's one of the best VR games I've played.
Yeah,
I've played quite a few now, and I think I'd reviewed Sniper Elite 4 the other week, didn't I? That was
Do you reckon you'll give it a go as a normal game just to see the difference?
No, I'm happy.
I wouldn't even content.
Yeah,
maybe play it on the Wii.
Is that more? Maybe that's more. Yeah, because the quick time events when you've got to like you know. Thrust your controllers.
Yeah.
Get the nunchuck out.
I suppose that's probably from the Wii, isn't it, Matt? Yeah.
Yeah. Does it give you like post game content? Like once you complete it? Or did you unlock like
I don't know. What is there? Oh, I suppose there is. Yeah, you get like guns and stuff.
But I mean like
DLC, I was like, oh.
Well, in Resident Evil 4 you unlock like a couple of new modes, like Mercenaries mode, there's a Ada Wong, which is a character from 2.
Yeah.
There's a whole like.
Who I never met.
Is there?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I was like, there might be more.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
Yeah,
I don't remember seeing that saying it was unlocked. I think you just get like some guns and you get like a golden typewriter.
Oh my god.
Oh, you didn't see that either. There's a fucking... Your save thing is the typewriter. You're actually typing on the typewriter.
That's pretty sick, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
That's such a small thing. But that's
I know, it's so small. Do you know one thing that actually blew me away as well? Is when you get a key, you actually put it in the door and you turn it. I was like, oh my god, that's so good.
So impressive.
I can imagine someone going, I turned it the wrong way. A bit like Skyward Sword where you were in the wrong direction. It's like, the key's not working.
They had turn a lot right. of like... They had a lot of cranks, actually, which I would turn the wrong way.
Oh, fucking hell, Christ.
Yeah, it was like clicking. I was like, why is this not doing anything? Oh, it's the other way. Yeah.
I think that's pretty cool. Totally. There's like...
Yeah.
there's been a couple of games where I'm like, I should get a VR headset.
You totally should. Like, I'm going to sell it some more now. That they've the one I've got is I think it's the 32 gig model, but now that doesn't exist. It's been discontinued, and now they're I think it's like the base one is, I can't remember what it is. Maybe mine's 64 gig, but the base model is now 128 gigs basically, and it's the same price as the one I bought.
Oh shit!
Which is like way less storage. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not that I really need it that much, but you just have to like juggle your games a bit.
Yeah, yeah.
But I totally recommend them. You know, they're cheaper than a console, and they're like so good. If you've got a great PC as well, you know, you can connect it to your PC. I'm just, this is an advert for Oculus Quest. I've been paid by Meta.
Do you love Beat Saber though?
I love Beat Saber.
And barbecue sauce.
And barbecue sauce. Yeah. Do you know where I saw my barbecue sauce? It's on the bookshelf. But yeah, totally recommend it. Totally recommend Oculus Quest just for that game alone. There's so many more I need to play that I'm sure I'll review on the podcast, but I'll get around to it at some point. But let's move on to another immersive experience in Sam's game, Ring Fit Adventure.
Ring Fit. There's less killing zombies in this one.
Yeah.
You haven't unlocked
more exercise as well.
Yeah, is there an ADO campaign?
Do you unlock the golden typewriter?
You have to like crunch in the fucking ring.
Like, you have to actually physically change the typewriter roll
for a space.
Yeah. Why did my parents name me something so long? Addison's just sitting there crying.
Gets to the yes, I can't do anymore. Fuck. Anyway, yeah. So I've been playing Ring Fit Adventure. So I had one of those moments a few weeks ago where I was just like, I need to lose weight. I need to get a bit fitter.
We've all been there.
And we're a body positive podcast. You know, we take bodies in all shapes and sizes. That sounds really weird. That sounded a bit Buffalo Bill, that.
Just a bit, yeah.
We
take
it anyway.
Send it by post.
Put
PO
the
box.
In the basket or it gets the hose again.
So I was like, what can I do to like lose weight? And you know, I did have a gym membership, but they're also expensive. And then after like 3 weeks, kind of stopped going. And I was going to get an exercise bike because I know Matt loves his exercise bike. And I was like, well, he lost a shit ton of weight, so I'll do it his way. But then I was like, it just sounds really boring to me. I don't know why.
That's why I play games while I do it.
It's like, why am I cycling to?
There's no destination here. So I was like, well, let me look up this Ring Fit Adventure and checked out a few reviews. Like, all of the reviews were like really positive and were saying like it's actually like a really good way to lose weight. So went on the old Facebook Marketplace and got up for like 30 quid.
Got a second-hand sweaty one.
Second-hand.
I'd say that's a good price, to be fair. During lockdown.
That's very good, yeah.
My partner got it in lockdown. I think it was like double the price.
Yeah, because I was going to get it new, and I think it's like 65 quid, because obviously it comes with like the ring.
The leg strap, you know, and yeah.
All the bits and bobs, yeah. But yeah, it's like 35 quid, I think. Matt's laugh.
Yeah, good.
He was definitely laughing at the strap on.
How you do your exercise, Matt, is down to you, okay? Let Sam do his.
Strapped it onto the exercise bike.
Yeah, I hope he doesn't use it in VR. So basically what it comes with is you get a ring, which is essentially like a resistance band. And I feel like I'm so cautious with every word that I'm using now because I'm just waiting for Matt to... You slide the Joy-Con...
Thrust!
You slide the Joy-Con into the big ring. Okay, great.
Yeah. So you slide the right Joy-Con into that one, and then you put your strap on your leg.
Don't want to put the wrong one in there.
No. You got to be careful. You got to be safe. Addison's lost the wheel.
A little bit, yeah.
All right.
We'll
tidy it up again. We'll tidy it up. You have a leg strap, which you put on your left leg, and you put the left Joy-Con in, and that kind of measures like your running.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, and I thought they both
went into the band.
No, yeah, so they kind of separate it to measure. Basically, the ring is the arms. The left Joy-Con is the leg movement. Did you guys ever play Wii Fit?
Yep.
No, I didn't, actually.
No. What did you think of it, Mark? Like, Wii Fit back in the day?
The Wii Fit back in the day, I think, was a really smart move. I think there was certain parts of it. Yeah, it was the balance board, and then it came with the game.
Yeah.
Essentially, you do your BMI and everything to start with.
Yeah.
And then you play certain games. But a lot of them were kind of silly games, like we got a head or a ball, but you just got to kind of move your feet a little bit. But you never came off the board. So there was a few games where you kind of wanted to jump where you couldn't.
Yeah,
straighten your legs up, and that's how it would distribute the weight.
That's right. That was like a skiing game, wasn't there?
Yeah, the skiing one was probably the best one, to be fair.
Yeah, but like, because I had that at one point, but I never felt like I got a good workout from it. It was always just kind of like, you know, I'm a little bit warmed up, and that was kind of it. Like,
it was a gimmick, really, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Whereas, I kind of wish I recorded my first try at this game, because fucking hell.
There's your soundbite.
I am, because it has a few game modes. So you had like the main adventure mode, where it's essentially like an RPG. It's kind of like really pretty cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, so you kind of like run through the levels. You kind of like the way you jump is you tilt the Rincon down and you kind of like squeeze it in and it kind of like Matt's face, and it kind of like blows a puff of air and it makes you jump.
Yeah.
And but then you run into enemies and you kind of have like turn-based battles, but like,
so are you like running on the spot for this?
Yeah, like running on the spot. Okay. And
oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. And then these turn-based battles you have, like, your moves are different exercises, so
okay.
So you do like squats and or like you know, put the ring on above your head and kind of like squeeze it in or pull it out. Fucking hell, these words are so fucking dodgy.
It's you. You're saying them.
It's your. It's Matt's face.
I'm never employing you as a PT.
But yeah, but so you have the main adventure mode, and then you have like you can just do just, you know, basic kind of exercises, and I think it was on my like second day, and I was doing like these kind of like ab workout, and I was like, oh, I'll do the advanced version, and it was like 7 stages, and I got like to the 4th one, and I was like, Alyssa, I can't do it. I literally cannot do it anymore. And she was like,
where's the bucket?
Yeah, I was like, fucking hell, this is impossible, and I had to kind of like cheat my way through the game. I was just like moving my left leg, like, fuck it. Shaking my left leg, trying to get through it.
But like the iToy back in the day, where you used to put one arm in front of it.
Is it easy to cheat if you like...
It's...
Because that's kind of a worry, isn't it, that you'll just sit there just like...
Doing your wrist exercise.
Yeah.
It's not as easy as you think, like, because it's actually kind of like quite impressive how they've used the Joy-Cons in this game, because like it really does, like, it's just crazy how it detects where, like, because you have, you know, some when you put the Rincon to the side and you sit on the floor with stretch your legs out, and before each exercise it makes sure you're in the correct position before it starts.
Okay.
And sometimes it's like, how the fuck does it know? Like, it's genuinely like crazy, like the technology that's in it. And one thing that like blew my mind was, do you know on the right Joy-Con at the bottom, it has that like little black piece, it's like
the IR sensor.
Yeah
So he uses that to measure your heartbeat through your thumb.
That's cool.
I was like, what the fuck, Nintendo? Like, where the fuck did that come from?
They have lots of secret tech on their Switches, don't they?
Yeah.
I know, yeah. I'm like,
they're tracking you.
Yeah.
But that's what I was thinking. Like, what else don't we know yet? Maybe there's like some surprise game in store.
Yeah.
I mean, they had audio, didn't they? Bloody Bluetooth audio in the Switch for 5 years and didn't turn on. So
there's
something else in there.
So weird.
Guess you guys can have that now.
Yeah, it's been a while.
But yeah, I mean, it's like I've been like genuinely shocked at how, because you can set alarms, you know, for each day to do your workout, and it basically like flashes the home button on the right Joy-Con, and I think it vibrates as well. And it, like, I'm generally surprised how into it I am, because like I think what I was looking for was, I always find exercise a bit boring. I think that's my problem. Like when I'm on a treadmill or something. I'm just, I get bored.
It's very, you know, autonomous.
I personally hate cardio. I just always get bored of doing stuff like that.
Yeah.
So yeah, we have looked, me and Billy have looked into getting one before and then kind of gone, yeah, but is it going to be any good? Like,
yeah.
Kind of balked at the price a little bit.
Yeah, so, yeah.
It's interesting. It's actually quite enjoyable. So maybe we'll look into that a bit more.
Yeah, I think because it combines like the adventure mode, especially it's because you gain like XP, you level up, you know, your stats grow and stuff like that. And like it, like each new, because it has like worlds, you know, like similar to like Mario. And there's like, I did like the first two worlds and was like, okay, yeah, this is the game kind of thing. And I got to like the third world, and then it starts doing this whole like, enemies have weaknesses, like, based on different colours, but like fucking okay. Pokemon with like, you know, water versus grass kind of thing. And so like certain exercises are assigned to different colours, so you have to like think about your moveset. I was like, what the fuck, this is crazy, like this is fucking so well thought through, like,
yeah.
So yeah,
the protagonist is redheaded as well, isn't it?
Yes, yeah.
So you're essentially Misty right now. Yeah. Send out your Staryu.
Yeah, if there's ever a Pokemon version of this game, I'm going to be there.
Oh, God, don't give him any ideas.
Hey, is that... You got that? Yeah.
But, is there any one game for this? Like, can you use that for anything else? Have they got expansions or anything?
Use it for Super Smash Bros.
Smash, yeah. Show your moves.
I think it's just for this, isn't it, at the moment? But I did remember hearing there was something else coming out. I think, yeah, it's been out 2-3 years now.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if they do bring anything else out. Or, like you said, some like DLCs or expansion packs. Because it would be cool to see it used more.
That's where the Wii Fit kind of failed, didn't it? Because it brought out the Wii Fit game, and then I don't really know how much use there was for it after that.
They seem to do this quite a lot, because I kind of put it in along with that Labo stuff, which is just like, cardboard. Yeah, then you've got the cardboard and that one thing that it works with, and then what else?
Yeah.
What's the point?
What's next? Just money.
Yeah. Money, that's the point.
Yeah, we all get what the point is, but... It'd be nice to have a bit more consumer-friendly sort of thing going on there, especially if you are buying this periphery.
You know it's Nintendo, yeah? They don't do anything consumer-friendly.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully they do, but I was surprised at how much like there is in this package, because there's loads of different modes. There's like a rhythm game, you know, kind of feels a bit like Guitar Hero, but obviously much more simplified down.
Beat Saber.
Yeah, I love Beat Saber.
Is it like those Just Dance games?
Kind of. Basically, it's like, it's really hard to describe without like a visual.
Or the dance mats. Do you remember the dance?
Yeah, it kind of reminds me of a dance mat in a way. Yeah. That's kind of what
dance,
I
dance revolution
a bit more. Yeah. With the ring, you have to kind of like do different like moves with the ring, like squeeze it in.
Okay.
Squat and I play like the Mario theme, which was fucking incredible.
Can you, like, change the resistance? Can you, like, add weight to it or anything?
You can't...
The band itself is very high resistant anyway.
Yeah, it's pretty high resistant. But also, like, the way you can increase the difficulty is it kind of does it based on, like, how long you have to, like, hold the resistance in or hold the squat or how many you do kind of thing. That's kind of how it, like, changes
time under tension.
Mm. Yeah, that's right, yeah. And there was one point when I upped the difficulty, got to a battle, and genuinely got my ass kicked. And I was like, what the fuck? Like, I'd never thought I would lose a battle in this game. Like, what the fuck is going on? So I had to take it back down a notch. But if you're looking for something to exercise with and you've got a Switch, I'd recommend it. I've played it for like a week and I've lost 6 pounds, so...
It's pretty good.
Yeah. So I'm hoping I can continue. I don't want to like just forget about it. So Matt, you'll have to be my my personal trainer. Right.
Yeah. Only if you wear a Mario hat.
Yeah. Speaking of Mario hats, I'm sure there's some of those in Mario Party Superstars.
Yeah, so I've been playing Mario Party Superstars, which is the brand new Mario Party that came out, what was it, a week and a half ago? So 29th of October for anyone, because obviously this will come out in a week's time. So I've currently played two of the maps. That is Princess Peach's Birthday Cake, which is from Mario Party 1.
Yeah.
And Horrorland, which is from Mario Party 2. Oh my god, they've been so much fun. So, if I don't know if you guys have ever played the any of have you played any of them actually? Like,
I've got the latest one before this one on the Switch, and then I've played one with you. But was it four?
Four, yeah, we played four. Yeah.
Which one is that? One on the GameCube.
Yeah, that's the GameCube one. That was the first GameCube one.
Wii, maybe.
Yeah. Didn't they went through a bit of a bad streak on the Wii and the Wii.
Yeah, so I think when it got to, I think Mario Party 8 on the Wii was probably the last good one in 2007. And then 9 and 10 were like this stupid where you're all on a car together.
Yeah,
that's right. Yeah, I think we played one once. I don't think we even played the whole game.
We were like, what the fuck is this? Why are we all travelling together? What's the point of rolling the die?
Yeah, it defeats like the object of the game.
So there's kind of the general consensus is the first six are kind of really well renowned, loved. The first three especially are kind of the best probably in the series. And the maps, there's five maps. The five maps are from the original three Mario Parties.
Yeah.
So you've got Princess Peach's Birthday Cake, like I said, Horrorland, and then you've also got Woody Woods from Mario Party 3, Yoshi's Tropical Island from Mario Party 1, and Spaceland from Mario Party 2. So where it differs from the last one that came out on the Switch, which I think it was a good release, it was better than what we've had for quite some time, but I think it lacked diversity between the maps. So like the warp pipe was in every single one. You could just warp pipe to the star for like, what was it, 15 coins or 10 coins or whatever?
10 coins, I think, yeah.
Yeah, it was just kind of really quite boring on that side. Whereas this, there is the warp pipe in Tropical Island, but it costs 25 coins to get there, which is more than a star, so it means you can't, it's not OP anymore. And then you have one in like Princess Peach's Birthday Cake where you buy a piranha plant, and the bigger piranha plant you buy can steal a star.
Oh right.
What else have you got? You've got the Booze Bell in another one where you can steal stars that way as well. And then there's Booze a return Bell,
that sounds fun.
And then you've got the
please.
Yeah, so this takes kind of the top 100 party games that they had for, kind of similar to the 3DS, the release that they had for that, like the top 100. But
yeah.
They've taken away some of the ones that weren't very good for the 3DS and put in kind of the fan favourites. The games that you have are from Mario Party 1 through to 10. So you've kind of got all the ones you love in there, like Book Squirm and the ones where you bash people up. It's brilliant.
And obviously they've like completely redone the modernized the graphics of the levels and stuff.
Yeah, so completely modernized it, but it's kind of such a lovely throwback to the originals that were so good.
Yeah.
So do you prefer this to the one that was on Switch that I have? The I can't remember the name of it. Is it just Super Mario Party?
I think, yeah, Super Mario Party. I think this is the best Mario Party there's been for quite some time.
Holy shit.
Okay.
And I don't know how much of that's nostalgia for the originals.
Yeah. I was going to say, the main problem, because I play this, the one that I've got with my siblings quite a lot, just because it's something fun to chuck on and kill some time. The main problem we have is there's only like four or five maps, and you get used to them very quickly, and then the same mini games always pop up, and then you'll get one that you haven't seen for like months.
Yeah, so the kind of the different thing with this game is you select your turns as standard, but you can pause the game midway through and add turns if you want, if you feel like the game needs to be a bit longer.
So that's cool. Yeah.
You can save a game. So if you need to go off for like 2 hours, you can save a game and come back to it. You can save up to 10 games concurrently, which I thought was really cool.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
The mini games before you go in, so there's a screen to select when you go in. So obviously you do your map as standard. You can choose the way that the stars are given out at the end. So you can choose the classic mode, which is based on most minigame wins, most coins. Mm-hmm. Or you can select the random one that they did for Super Mario Party. It can be just based on like whoever moved the most steps. So you can add that. You have the minigame, obviously standard. And then you can also choose what type of minigames you get. So you can choose one that's based on skill. You can choose it based on family. And then you've got, you can just choose the N64 ones or just choose the GameCube ones.
Okay.
I think the only letdown, and it's the letdown I feel for the previous one, is the 3v1s are a bit OP for the... It's either it's really sided for the three, or it's really sided for the one. And that's always been a problem.
Yeah.
But I think with this, the stuff they've added, so the chance star is back, the chance space is back. So the chance space was in the first six. If you landed on the chance space, basically you do the little jump that you do to do your die roll. And then it will choose your character. You do the other die roll, chooses the other character, and it will choose whether you switch stars with them or you switch coins with them. So in theory, you can go, you can be fourth, go into that chance space area.
Jesus Christ.
And then you've just flipped. You're in first now because you've taken all the stars for someone else.
Like, yeah, if you haven't played these if you haven't played these games much, they're fucking bullshit sometimes.
Yeah, clearly.
Yes, yeah, so you've got stuff like Monopoly. That. In Horrorland, Horrorland is like there's a two-roll cycle of day and night. And when you're in the night cycle, you can go up to Boo and you can buy star. You can take someone else's star away from them. There's a lot of stuff in the game where you can kind of steal the stars, and it feels more bullshit this time around. Not, I suppose bullshit's not probably the word. It's like it's going to be bullshit for the person that's playing it when they're getting stolen from.
Yeah,
whereas I feel
yeah.
like the last one, very much it was, if you're winning, that's it. You were going to win it.
Yeah, that's pretty pants. Okay. Yeah.
Whereas this, it can go anywhere.
Yeah, I like that when it happens. So there's only five maps.
Yeah, there is only five maps. I think, obviously, you've got one more than... I hope they do.
Because it's not a lot, is it, five? Considering they're from every single Mario Party game.
They will probably not release any more because they didn't on the last one either.
That's ridiculous.
I think if they were smart, they'd DLC it.
Yeah, they did with the last one, so I can't see why they would on this one, because it's Nintendo.
Yeah, it'll be a new game.
Yeah.
You're supposed to have five
years after you wanted to play the last one.
But it's weird, though, because you got, like, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Is it Ultimate on the Switch? Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Which has got, like, every single character that's ever been in Smash Bros., like, most, probably every map as well. Like, why can't they do that with Mario Party? Because surely it's the same sort of thing. And they're both Nintendo properties, so why don't they do that?
Yeah.
Especially because this is a
different
throwback.
Divisions who make it.
Sorry?
Because you think you've got the original three Mario Party maps in this. Why would you not take the originals anyway? And just go, here we go.
Yeah. But I just felt like five isn't enough. Just not.
So the, especially for I'm aware the online game. The online mode is meant to be very good.
Okay.
The minigame section, they've got kind of... I think that was in the last one, wasn't it? Super Mario Party?
I feel like they brought it in really late, the online mode.
Oh, they did.
It was almost like a year and a half after.
No, I think it was for lockdown. I think it was just before.
Oh shit. Yeah.
I think that's it was like super, super late. Yeah.
Mm.
More than that, this game came out in 2018.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are you doing, Nintendo?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how long does, like, what's like the average, you know, time to complete a map with like four players?
So 20 turns, which is the minimum, is about an hour, I'd say, which is a nice time to sit down. But I think if you sit and do 20 turns, obviously in the past, that's it, game over. Whereas now, if I want to add another 20 on because we're having fun and we want another hour to play, you can.
That's pretty cool.
That's good.
Yeah, I like that feature.
Mm. Yeah.
And I think that because the maps are all quite different, so Peach's Birthday Cake, the one we played, is the stars in a fixed position. So you've just got to get round to that again. So you kind of want to use items like Triple Die to get round the full run quicker.
Yeah.
But then you've also got the piranha plants that you can plant earlier in the game for coins that can steal stars. So it means you're like, as you go round more times, there's more risk of you losing your stars.
It's exactly
sounds more like a board game than some of the other ones.
Yeah, it kind of feels like it's gone back to its roots. It feels like a proper board game. So then, like Spaceland, for instance, there's a section in the middle of the map. If you go in it and the rockets go off, you lose all your coins.
Right.
So you kind of got to be cautious where you land. Horrorland, there's like different areas that you can go in based on night and day. Or if you've got like a key gate as well, like a key for the gate. So it's kind of, there's different ways of playing each one. And there's different special items in each one as well, which I thought was really cool.
Mm.
So there's no like, oh, I played it this way, I'm going to play the next one the exact same way. It feels different. And I think that's what I liked.
That's good. At least I got that. But yeah.
Also, there was one thing I noticed as well. When you land on the Bowser space, it's like you lose a star potentially.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was an option in there to win 100 stars.
What the fuck?
Jesus Christ, how often does that come up?
I would love to see it.
Must be like a 1 in 1 million chance or something.
Yeah, fucking hell.
Also, there was one other thing as well that a lot of people would be kind of talking about probably online fairly soon, is there was a mini game in the second or third one that broke a lot of the Nintendo sticks. It was the tug of war one.
Oh, yeah.
So people used to like kind of put their hand flat on it and then roll it around to the point where they get blisters. I think if you complain to Nintendo, Nintendo will send you a glove. That's their way of like saying sorry.
Oh, my God.
They've brought this back for the Switch.
No
way. But they say there's like a little advisory in the game guide of how to play it. It's like, please do not use your palm, basically, because you will fuck up the Joy-Con.
I feel like that's not any faster than with the thumb, but... I'm sure it probably is. I don't know.
I'm doing a test. Yeah, I feel like palm would be faster. Yeah.
It's like, why is my Joy-Con drifting?
They just don't want to send out any more fucking gloves. Like, we don't want to spend money making these fucking gloves.
We don't want to send any more Michael Jackson gloves out at all.
Yeah, so for me, I think if you were going to pick up a Mario Party, this would be the one.
The one.
Yeah.
The
yeah, I mean, I know I probably will at some point just because of how much my family likes to play these games.
Is it 55 quid?
It came out at 45, but then I sold my old Mario Party and a few other things, so
yeah, that's a lot, isn't it?
Just traded in.
Switch games so bloody expensive.
Matt like hates spending money on Switch games.
I do.
45 is really like 40, right. So 45 is high. I fully appreciate that. Before, like, that's not as bad as FIFA that just released on Xbox that came out for like £80.
Yeah, that's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Thank god.
Like, children buy those games.
That's why we praise Game Pass so much.
Game Pass.
Yeah.
But it is so fucking good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're going to go on to our driving games portion of it. Talk about our favourite driving games. It's a bit Jeremy Clarkson there. We were discussing the other day what we're going to talk about on our podcast. I think one of us jokingly suggested doing something to do with cars.
It might have been... Yeah, I think it was probably me.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll let him take the rap for this, Sam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it kind of evolved into us talking about our favourite driving games, because I like cars, which has probably come up on many of the other episodes. Yeah. It's not really a surprise. I'm not like a car mad person, though. So it's not.
He's not married to his car.
Disagree.
Not yet. So we talk about some driving games that we've played like throughout the years, because Forza Horizon 5 is coming out literally tomorrow from when we're recording this podcast, which I'm quite excited for. Don't know about you guys.
It's got a 10 out of 10, isn't it? From IGN.
Yep.
From IGN. Yeah.
Couldn't give Addison to anyone.
Couldn't give a shit.
Yeah. Got it downloading on my Xbox as we speak.
Literally the last one is set where he lives, so I don't know why he doesn't want to play it.
Why would I give a fuck?
I can drive it in real life. It's just full of fucking traffic.
I could drive it IRL.
For a tourist, more like.
Yeah.
And trams. Ooh, look, Edinburgh Castle. Mm. Let's do a donut.
Can you do
I've
that
seen
in
it
life?
In Fast and Furious 9. Why would I need to see it in anything else?
Jesus, yeah.
I forgot about that. Oh my god.
Why do I need to go outside? So yeah, we're going to talk about driving games. And going on from Super Mario, or Mario Party Superstars, whatever the fuck it's called. There's so many fucking names for them.
I'm glad you paid attention, Matt. Thank you.
Yeah. I was writing the last one. I think that's right. I'm going on to Addison's one then, which is Mario Kart, isn't it?
Yeah, specifically for me, Mario Kart 8, which is the one on Switch that originally came out on the Wii U.
It did. Yeah.
I did not have
it on the
Wii
U.
I do have a Switch. and for me, as a person who hates car games and is so excited for this week, this was the only game that I enjoy that is a car game, really. Even my special mention isn't really a car game. Yeah, this is just the classic racing game, isn't it? I don't know anyone who hasn't really played it and
not enjoyed it. No, it's such a like renowned
game, just a game in general. Like, if anyone, it's a party game, isn't it, really? More than anything.
Oh, massively. And as someone who doesn't enjoy card games, never has, it is one of the only ones I've ever kind of actually sat down and played properly, even just by yourself sometimes, when you're just like, oh, I just need to chuck something on for 5 minutes, I'll play play a lap of Mario Kart. It's the only racing game I would ever do that with, and probably will ever do with, I imagine, unless you guys make me play Forza 5.
just hold his hands. Just force him.
Yeah.
Do like you drive. Orange.
You drive this car around Scotland for fuck's sake.
You fucking do a donut in Edinburgh Castle.
I think just by 8, I've played some of the older ones, but I think by 8 they've kind of perfected that sort of formula. It is a perfect Mario Kart game.
Did you
in
play
my
Double
eyes.
Dash though?
I have. Yeah. There's a video game bar near here called, like, I think it's like, oh, I can't remember the name.
It doesn't matter, because we'll be visiting when we come to visit you.
Yes, we'll be.
Yeah, we'll spot it out.
There's Christmas sorted.
But they have video games all set up, and they have the Double Dash there, which was quite fun.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
We'll definitely stop by there.
Yeah. That's the only thing that Mario Kart 8 is missing, is the Double Dash mode, because I love the idea of having two characters on the cart. Like,
I would not be surprised if the next one they do is something like that.
It's got to be. It's got to be. Where else can you go? Something.
Yeah. Because as I said, it is basically Mario Kart perfected. It is just, everything is so tight and controls perfectly. It just all feels so good. It's got so many maps.
And the graphics are like phenomenal.
And the graphics are so good.
Yeah.
It's one of the best looking games on the Switch.
It really is. They really like get everything out of it, which is surprising for the Switch.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the gliding stuff? Because that came in 7, wasn't it? The DS one?
Yeah, I'll take it or leave it. I'm not mad that it's there. Like, it's fine. No, it's just whatever it is, isn't it? It's not there enough to annoy you.
Yeah, that's true. It's not like, you're going, here's a space game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, if there was, like, levels dedicated to it, then yeah, it'd be a very different story. But it's normally just a small section that lasts about not even 30 seconds.
No, yeah, they're normally pretty short. Yeah,
pretty much. So it's whatever.
I think the most is, like, one of them is probably, like, a quarter of the map, is it? But That's about it, really. Yeah, no, it's an absolutely great game, though.
The one downside with these games is always the sort of positive feedback loop for the person in first place, because if you get in first early on, you are pretty much set.
Yeah. Well, some objects can fuck you over.
Apart from that fucking blue shell.
Yeah.
Yes, but how often does that actually affect you enough to even knock you back?
Yeah, that's true.
You haven't faced us.
Yeah, I wonder if they'll take the kind of same route as this new Mario Party's done, with making the difficulty a little bit harder, so you don't completely run away with it.
I think that would be a good addition for these, like, because they already have the blue shell stuff, and you do get better power-ups the further back you are.
Yeah.
But the leads you can sometimes get is just insane.
Mm. Yeah. One thing I'd love to see them, this, again, to talk about Double Dash, but I remember with Double Dash you had, like, character-specific items, and they kind of took that away.
That would be cool, yeah.
And like, because you had, like, with Yoshi, you could, like, throw a Yoshi egg, or I can't remember any of the other ones, but I think in 9, they should bring that back. It's a great feature.
Yeah, I'd like to see something like that.
Really memorable.
It would be small stuff like that, wouldn't it? Like, because the driving is just so on point in this game.
Yeah. So the driving is perfect.
Yeah,
you can't do
by this point. The, yeah,
even the battle modes are actually all right in this game. Whereas I could
take
them.
Yeah, I can't say I've played them too much, but when I have, I've always gone, I should play these more.
They're actually, especially Mario Kart 8, they're a lot more like fleshed out. Some of the older ones are just like really basic, and this is actually quite a good one actually for battling. I've done it a bit online.
Is it in 8, they've got quite a few. They're starting to bring characters from other Nintendo franchises, aren't they? Like, you can play as Link.
Yeah, they've got Link. They've got Animal Crossing stuff. Yeah.
I think you can have Mercedes.
Mercedes they brought in.
Fucking Mercedes. So weird.
Yeah, there's a few crossover. Oh, Splatoon is the other one I'm thinking of.
Oh, yeah.
So they've got a few things like that. Yeah.
I thought you were going to say your mum. I was like, fucking hell, man.
Your mum. Yeah.
Only if you've made her as a me.
If they've got a lot of these characters in Smash, They could, in theory, then pull him over to Mario Kart 9, surely.
I'll play as Solid Snake in
Mario Kart. Is he in Mario? Super, is he in Super
Smash Bros?
Yeah.
Yeah. He came in Brawl.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fighting games, a genre I also do not give two shits about.
Let's do that next time. Yeah.
That's our next topic.
Yeah.
Favorite Smash Bros.
With fighting games, actually.
None of them.
The one that is burning.
Yeah. With fighting games, sometimes I'll take it or leave it. But, yeah. We're not talking about this week.
But what if you're fighting with cars?
Sorry.
Like in Mad Max.
Like Robot Wars.
Oh, actually, imagine Mario Kart Robot Wars.
Oh, yeah. Do you want me to do my special mention now, or are we doing them all at the end?
Oh, I don't know. I was going to do it now, but you could do it at the end. I've already segued to it now.
Yeah.
Go for it.
Yes, right. my special mention is my cheaty way of getting out of not
a
picking
driving
a driving
yeah.
game, and I chose Mad Max, which came out around about 2015 or so, maybe. Time as Fury Road. And I, weirdly enough, I feel like this was poorly affected by Metal Gear Solid 5 coming out, because it came out like the same day or something.
Yeah, same day or week at least.
And whilst they're not similar, everyone was so hyped on MGS5.
Yeah.
I think this kind of suffered a little bit, which is a shame because it is an amazing game that has this Arkham style combat system that's very weighty.
It's open world as well, isn't it?
Yeah, so it was like
that's
in the
cool.
prime time of those big sandbox Ubisoft style, get up somewhere high, find all these stuff to do.
Yeah.
And it was kind of that sort of game. Very similar to Shadow of Mordor, I find.
In the
way it played. Yeah. I would say that's probably the closest game, because it was open world, you kind of went in these places, and the combat was kind of similar.
Okay.
But it also had driving mechanics in it, where you would like fight other cars.
That's
you could upgrade sick. Your... car, I can't remember what the name of it was, but the whole point was you were
Matilda.
Meant to be upgrading this car and making it this badass thing so you could take on this boss at the end.
That's pretty cool, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, and the driving mechanics were really good. I think half the problem, it kind of relates to my problem with the horses in games, is I can't drive cars in games. This one just it works quite well. With its driving mechanics and
some horses
like
and
that.
Games
that
are fucking awful, like MGS5,
we've discussed it before. I had a rant last time, I'm pretty sure.
Red Dead Redemption is probably one of the better ones.
Great game, not just a driving game, thankfully, for me, because I would have gone insane if it was.
Is there shooting?
And
is there shooting?
That's my special mention.
It's one that I've always you ever have those games where they're on your list
forever.
You build above them.
You're like, oh, well, I'd rather play that. This game is one of those. Like, I'm pretty sure I've downloaded it on my Xbox.
Yep.
I think it was on Game Pass. I'm thinking, I'm going to play that, and then just fucking never did. Didn't have to clear
I was so hyped on Fury Road. I was like, I want to watch everything Mad Max. Oh my God, there's a game coming out. I am on that. So I played it straight away, and it's a great game. Definitely, it's not like the best game ever, definitely middle of the road sort of thing, but definitely worth a go.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Shadow of Mordor, if you played that, is probably the most similar thing.
Okay.
Hmm. All right, okay. Well,
despite the driving mechanics.
Yeah. Yeah, there's not that in Shadow of Mordor.
Just all the orcs
it's
drifting.
Car in Middle Earth. What the
fuck? But
got no idea how to segue.
I was talking about it, so feel free to move on.
Got no idea how to segue it, so I'm just going to go with Sam. What are you going to talk about?
Hello there. Yeah, so I think my favourite, it is, because I
think you've chosen it.
I think my favourite. Yeah. so Need for Speed Underground 2 holds a special place in my heart.
Ooh.
It's just like, I remember when the first Need for Speed game came out, and that was like really cool. You customized cars, and it was kind of like, oh, it's like Fast and Furious. The second one came out, and I think this was the first one where it was a bit more open world, where you could like drive around the city, drive to your races, because I don't think the first one had that, if I remember rightly.
Oh god,
I think it was just
remember.
Like yeah. customize your car and then select your races.
Yeah, it was pretty locked down, the first one.
Yeah, so the second one was like, you know, it was just amazing. It was like, fucking hell, I've got this car that I've customized, and now I can like drive it around. And it really, like,
neon lights were a big thing then, weren't they, on the cars?
Oh, so good. Yeah, because it was like right in the middle of like those first two Fast and Furious films.
They were, yeah.
And
totally inspired.
I've said that before,
yeah.
I'm sure. Yeah, on our Fast and Furious episode, that I went out of my way to make that fucking skyline in the two Fast and Furious.
Silver, blue stripe, blue neon.
What a fucking beauty.
Racing for pink slips.
It is a car. It is a car.
That is a car, yeah. That's a great car, actually. That's a car, right? Yeah.
I will be very quiet from this point on.
One I liked
you guys
was...
have played it?
Yeah, nope. I did. I've played Need for Speed Carbon more, I think. Which I think is the one after it.
I've got
it?
Both copies behind me right now.
Ooh.
I couldn't tell you for certain, but it's entirely possible I've never played a Need for Speed.
You've played both of them, but...
Have I? Okay.
Yeah, you've played it when you've met up.
Okay. I'm sure I have then. Yes, I have played these.
Because Mark forced them onto you.
Very memorable, I would say.
not by choice, like every driving game with Addison.
Yeah.
Mark was like, you're going to play this fucking game. You're going to make that skyline from Two Fast and Furious.
This week's topic was such a good idea from me.
I'm such a genius. I bet you're glad.
But that's
such a good looking car, though, for the time. Probably looks. It's a bit dated now, but yeah.
The graphics when you go back to that game, not so good.
I happened to stumble across someone streaming it on Twitch and was like, oh, this is great. This is like, you know, I knew I was going to talk about it on the podcast. I was kind of watching it. I was like, I shouldn't have done this. I should have stayed in my memories.
It's kind of how I felt when I replayed Mass Effect when they remastered it. I was like, this should have stayed in my memories.
I always look at getting that collection. I'm like, just don't do it.
I think two and three are probably fine, but the first one is just so like empty.
I know.
That first one is an old game now.
It is, yeah. I remember it being so much better.
And that has some of the worst driving ever.
Oh, yes, fuck me. The Maker, is it? Something
like
that.
Fuck that thing.
That's
even. They tried to improve it, didn't they? But I've heard it's still pretty naff.
It's okay, but I remember it's exactly the same as I remember. Yeah,
it was. It was slightly better, but that is not saying much.
No. Yeah, that's not great. Not the greatest driving.
EA
game.
Recently dropped, didn't they? They dropped quite a lot of the Need for Speed games onto Game Pass.
Did they?
Oh, did they?
Oh, because
I'd already picked up one for the Switch. I have Hot Pursuit. So it's where you kind of take turns being the police or...
Yeah, I tried to play that.
Driveway.
I tried to play that. I wasn't that keen on it.
It's not so good now in terms of remaster, but it looks really good on the Switch. It kind of gave me... I don't know, Sam probably is the only one here that would have played it. Need for Speed Most Wanted on the PSP.
Oh, yes! Oh, my God! Oh, yeah, what a game. It gives me that vibe when I've got
it in my hands. It's just like so much fun to play undocked.
Yeah, I fucking that. Yeah, because I think I played the PSP version. I think I might own that, but also just the console version of that game. That game was one of the best Need for Speeds. That because they did like a second one, didn't they? Which I think they just named it the same.
I think
a second Most Wanted. But it was like the 2012 edition or something.
Second Most Wanted.
Yeah, not as Most Wanted.
Not as Most Wanted. Least Wanted.
Yeah. It's just a casual driver game, yeah.
Just a Peugeot 106 or something, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that's such a mad joke, that.
Peugeot 106 is a box car.
Okay. But it's I just have such good memories with this game. It's like, it was... You know, everyone has that, like that. I think it's probably like Mark with GTA, where you like, you have that moment where you're like, oh my god, like when GTA 3 was released and people were like, fucking hell, you can like explore the city.
This is 3D.
Oh my god,
GTA 5 on the Xbox 360, Xbox One, Series X. Next thing that's coming out. Wow.
On your Apple Watch.
Kind of... Fuck it, I wouldn't be surprised. Oh my god,
I'd be okay with that.
Well, Skyrim is on Alexa, isn't it? I'm pretty sure. You can play Skyrim on Alexa.
I think they did it as like a joke, and it was kind of on there.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah. That's fucking crazy. Oh my god.
That's
Do you think
one
your
thing
love
I
for this game is entwined with the films? Because of Fast and Furious, because obviously I know we spoke about it quite a lot on the Fast and Furious podcast.
Definitely, yeah. I think it was like, I saw Fast and Furious, like one and two, specifically as like, I don't know what age I was when they came out, but quite young. And it was kind of like, then this game came out where it's like, you can make those cars. And it was just kind of like, oh my god, that's fucking incredible. Like, I can't wait.
that was the thing that is amazing about it. It's one of the first bunch of games that you can actually customize a car, wasn't it? I think.
Yeah.
And they were actually like real cars, not like, you know, GTA's cars where they're like the Nostromo or whatever, you know.
Because normally it was just Nostromo. It was just the paint job, wasn't it? It was like you could have a red car, black car, but that was it. It was never down to the line of like doing decals and neon.
Yeah.
When you like said customizing, wheels. My first thought, oh, you can recolor them. That's cool.
I can have a blue car.
You got to put your fucking neon lights on.
Oh yeah.
They make it go faster.
That makes it lighter.
This is Addison from now on. Just
the worst.
Yeah.
He's driving me up the wall.
Hey, welcome to the Tepid Take.
That's a sign. That's it.
Yeah. And then, oh yeah, should I do my special mention? Rocket
if you League. Like, Sam. If you like, yeah. Oh, Rocket League.
You can lead me in if you want.
I don't know how, to be honest. How would you go from that to that? I don't know. So what, you can customise cars in Need for Speed. Can you customise cars in your second game?
Oh, you sure can, Matt. with Rocket League.
We're still in bag.
It really works. Rocket League. This is something about Rocket League. I think I first played it on the Switch. It was like one of the first games I got on the Switch.
Yeah, it's pretty awful on that.
I mean, when you've got a handheld, it's not too bad.
Did Matt have this at uni on PC? Have I made that up?
Who, me? Called something else before.
Oh, do you know what I had? Yeah, because they actually released something called Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Powered Battle Cars.
I'm
and that was on PS3, and it was made by the same people. And that was basically the same game as Rocket League, but it was nowhere near as successful.
No.
Oh, so is that what we played at uni? Because I always thought we just played Rocket League super early.
I don't know when Rocket League came out. I don't think.
Early access. Somewhere.
Just had developer codes.
Yeah.
But this was like 2013 at the latest.
Yeah, it would have been, wouldn't it? Yeah. It came out in 2015, so it must have been that game, Supersonic
Rocket League. Oh, I just always thought I'd played that really. Called.
Yeah, but it's the same game. It's exactly the same game. It's football with robots.
Cars,
whatever.
Yeah. With robots.
Yeah.
It's robot wars with cars.
It's robot wars with cars.
I was so keen on this one. I played it before it was even a game.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I actually hate
this game.
I know, because I remember... Yeah. Obviously we
Which kind of surprises
together.
Me.
Why?
I don't know. I just feel like you like the arcadey game.
Yeah, it's very arcadey.
Mario Kart.
Yeah.
Oh, I like Mario Kart. Mario Kart's fun.
It is very
It doesn't
on
play
par
like
Mario
Kart, though, does it?
No.
But it is kind of like on the same level.
If Mario was sat on top of the car, would you enjoy it?
Oh, there is
Mario, basically.
There is a Mario version of the car on the Switch and a Luigi one.
Oh, you can get a hat, can't you?
and you can get a hat, yeah. Yeah, because I remember when
what does the car look like, Mario or something? Is that Mario's face?
Yeah. Oh god, that'd be fucking terrified if it's Mario's face on the car.
Mario's face driving around.
It's a huge moustache. Fucking hell. Stuff of nightmares.
Batter that into the goal. Doosh.
Because I remember
me,
when we started.
Mario.
I was so excited for us all to play it, and I think we played it once, and then you guys were like, nah. I think Matt, you don't mind it, do you?
I like it. I really like it. I've played it loads.
I was fairly good at it.
Oh, it was just Addison. I thought
the whole time Addison.
I don't think you
like,
liked it though.
It.
Yeah.
No, Mark, you didn't like it at the time either.
You definitely didn't like it at the time.
My problem is, I'll score occasionally, but the rest of the time I'm just trying to get to the ball. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
That's the fun of the game.
You're just annoyed it wasn't FIFA.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what it'd be.
Yeah, I can imagine you would.
I'm sure you would.
I just always find the controls of it more frustrating than it's worth.
Mm.
It just annoyed me too much.
I think once you play it more, you get used to it.
Yeah, there's a bit of a learning curve with like the whole.
I'm also not big on sports games or racing games.
What games do you like, Anderson?
Do you like any fucking games?
Anything but racing, sport, or fighting games.
MGS, kind of.
Yeah. Resident Evil.
Kind of. There needs to be like.
I actually don't like games. I'm not a fucking nerd.
From Software need to make a Dark Souls racing game.
Yes. Oh my god, I would be so on that.
Dark Souls,
where you are the ball.
Racing game. Yeah. Yeah, you're the ball.
Everyone's trying to get you.
Every yeah. level is Rainbow Road. But yeah. demons.
Just blood. The roads of blood.
I would yeah. fucking. That would be such a great game.
That's the Bloodborne one.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
He's like, makes get sense. It right, get it right.
Yeah. Get it right, fuck cool. me. I don't think I've played any of them. I played Dark Souls once for like 10 minutes.
Yeah, I played like in that.
They're games I don't like.
Two, 3 hours in the Bloodborne and was like, I can't do it.
I'm sure you put Dark Souls
on
VR.
We will talk about this more when Elden Ring comes out.
I'm sure we will.
It's cool. We'll put a pin in this for now.
Yeah. But yeah, Rock League, I always forget how much I love it until like, it's kind of one of those games where like the World Cup will be on and I don't want to play FIFA. So I'm like, oh, I'll play a bit of Rocket League. And I'm like, fucking hell, I fucking love this game. Why don't I play this game more? And then
because none of us will play it with you.
Pretty much. I've got no friends to play it with.
So. There is a football game you could play by yourself. Do Football Manager. Throw some water bottles around.
Oh, God. That's what they need to put into Rocket League. The ability to throw a water bottle at other players.
At a car. Bounce off.
I mean, that sounds like something Mario Kart would do, to be fair.
That's true, yeah. Although I guess, yeah,
be a good
Red
weapon.
Shells are more fun.
I suppose they are probably less, you know, serious as well.
Yeah.
Well, if you threw a red shell at someone in real life, it'd probably fucking hurt.
Probably would, bolt. Actually. They're quite hard.
Yeah. And the turtle would be pretty upset about it.
We've just got rid of plastic straws to save them. You're fucking throwing them around. Jesus.
Fucking have this. So, moving on to some older games. I'm gonna go next. Fuck you, Ark.
He's like, I'm the host, bitch.
So one of my favourite games growing up as a child, as a children,
a wee boy.
is
Colin McRae. I don't know if you pluralise the fact that you were two children. The implications are not.
I don't know where to go from here.
He was playing Double Dash with his twin that he's now murdered.
I murdered, yeah. Consumed.
I think it's a weird. Double Bash. I was like, what fucking game is that?
This is weird now. No.
Alright.
Moving on. So one of my favourite games as a child for racing. I wasn't like... Weirdly, I didn't get into cars really until I was like... I had a car. So like 17. Or about then. And then...
What, no one drove you around?
Yeah, but I wasn't. I'm never a good passenger, so I hate fucking being a passenger in anyone's car. I like driving a car, not so much being a passenger.
Yeah, 15 is going, Dad, do a left.
Do a left, yeah. My dad's fucking mental as well when he's driving. So
your dad's getting too busy angry at the roads.
Yeah, yeah. Who designed this road? Yeah, that's my dad. Yeah.
Why is this roundabout here?
But my dad's actually going to get a mention in this, but... So one of my favourite games, or one of the games I most remember anyway, from growing up, is Colin McRae Rally on the PS1. And
wow.
I actually played that one.
Did you? Yeah. It's you know, it's a rally game. It's like what you'd expect. There's someone telling you directions and you go those directions and you're going across. It's like a time trial, basically. So, you know, if you like that sort of thing, it's okay. It's not like a racing game as per se. But
yeah.
Do you know what I really enjoyed about that game?
What?
Making your own tracks that were just broken.
So you can make your own tracks?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
If it's the one I'm thinking of, yeah.
Weirdly, I don't think you could do that anymore on the latest games. I don't think that's an option.
Maybe they.
Yeah, or it might be. I don't know. I've not tried it. But it's it definitely holds up in my memory. I think the thing I remember most about it is I used to play it with my dad, and my dad used to be shit at video games. He probably, well, he probably still is. He doesn't want to know.
I love you, like, my dad's going to get mentioned. You're shit.
Thing is, we get into that weird generation now where, like, we've grown up with video games. So when we have kids, yeah, we're like, right, yeah, you're going to get wrecked now.
Yeah. Fucking Mario Kart, you're going to get shit. Shit on. You're going to be in last place in Mario Kart. Yeah, fuck you. But, yeah, my dad used to be rubbish, and I used to be, like, I used to be sympathetic, and I would not do it properly, so he would catch up, so he wouldn't feel as bad and not play with me.
That's kind of cute.
Yeah, it was so stupid. I should have just thrashed him. I would now.
That's what I would have done.
Yeah, but I'm actually shit at racing games, like, awful. I'm not good at them at all. They're really, really
pretty
difficult.
Pretty good at Mario Kart.
Yeah, Mario Kart's a good one, but that's not really a racing game as per se, is it?
Nah, it's kind of like the same thing.
Yeah. Yeah. But,
literally,
yeah, so,
is a racing game.
Well, yeah, it is, yes. It's not a car racing game. It's a kart racing game.
There's a Mercedes in it. What the
There's
fuck?
A difference.
Okay.
There really isn't. Yeah, so this game, I actually, like, I looked back at some of the footage or some of the game just to, like, you know, refresh my memory. It doesn't look as bad as I thought it would. It's kind of like obviously blocky and, like, you know, low resolution, but it's actually like if you had like a indie game that made like a rally game. There is actually one at the moment called Art of Rally, which is, you know, it's kind of pixely art. It's not quite the same. It's like top down, but you can kind of expect that Colin McRae Rally would actually fit into that sort of genre, like an indie racing genre, which so it doesn't actually, it holds up all right. Probably better than Metal Gear Solid 1, but it's not like there's a story or anything. It's just a fucking racing game.
I fully agree with you there.
Yeah.
I'm sure it fucking does.
Yeah. And similar to the Nissan Skyline, you could drive the Subaru Impreza, which is a very similar looking car, actually. And it's Colin McRae's, you know, Colin McRae's fucking signature car, basically. Yeah. It is a car, but it's his signature car. The blue and yellow
signed it and everything.
So it's got a signature.
Yeah, it's kind of weird when you think about it. If you've got Tony Hawk skating games, you've got what is it, Matt Hoffman BMX, and then Colin McRae.
A lot of sports games on the PS1. I feel like there's less nowadays. There are obviously some, but, you know, there's not like a huge amount of, like, skateboarding games or anything.
Big name brands were quite a big thing for quite a while, weren't they?
Yeah. I mean, Colin McRae was the name of all the rally games for years and years, pretty much until he died. Yeah.
The last new one I can think of was it Sean Ryder's snowboarding?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fucking hell, yeah.
Which was like on the Wii or something.
At least 10 years ago.
Oh, do you remember Cool Borders? That was a good game. That was on PS1.
You're talking to the wrong person here. Doesn't like sports, doesn't like driving, doesn't like fighting, doesn't like games.
That was a snowboarding game. But yeah, that's such a, like, a staple of my childhood, I feel. Just playing that game. I don't know if I even enjoyed it that much, but it just sticks in my memories. Yeah, it was probably one of the first racing games. And I continue to play, like, those sort of games. I played, like, the most recent Dirt Rally game. And it's, like, it's pretty enjoyable. Dirt Rally 1 is in VR as well, which is fucking disgusting.
I bet that's fucking trippy.
That's gotta be so weird.
Also, I did it with
scratching to your TV.
Yeah. Just go flying into the wall. Oh, that is pretty, like, that's one thing that did make me a little bit motion sick. Yeah. It's difficult as well. I don't normally get motion sick like that, but it definitely did it. And I tried to play with the steering wheel, and I was just shit at it. Absolutely awful. So I kind of gave up on that. Yeah. I
found, like, the steering wheels for video games,
they're just not like shit. Like a real, they don't feel like a real car, do they?
No.
There's no real feeling. It kind of is annoying. I don't know if you get, like, a mega expensive one. They're, like, amazing. I don't know. But they always feel like...
Thing, isn't it? You have to get the balls expensive ones to make it even worth it.
There is a white plastic one that was very good for Wii Mario Kart. Stick it around the outside of the motion controller. Ooh, wonderful.
You can get them for the Switch. They're a bit smaller.
Oh, you can, can't you? Yeah.
Maybe you could use the Ring Fit for make it like a racing game.
Like a massive steering wheel. Yeah.
You play like a trucker game.
Yeah. Like a bus
simulator.
That would work. You just use one of the Joy-Cons as like the 17 fucking gears.
That's one thing as well. It's weird in video games when they like you get the option to do manual gears in a car. Like, it's so weird.
Yeah, it never feels
on a driving game.
Right.
Never feels right. No. But in a normal car, it's fine. In real life, it's fine. You know. But yeah, so that's, you know, that was a big part of my childhood. And I think I enjoyed it at the time. I think I was more like, I think it was kind of the time when there were better games like Crash Bandicoot to play. So that
the
was
the racetrack builder part of it was just
was it like Forge in Halo?
Similar sort of thing. If you ever played the original Far Cry's as well, it was kind of similar to their like world
okay.
building.
Cool. Or, I don't think I ever made a map.
Tony Hawk's.
In... Do you know what I did make a map in? Was Time Splitters Future Perfect, which is another PS1 game. I think. That was a good game. I might have a PS2
game.
You
did that in Tony Hawk. You build your own like.
That was the big thing in Tony
could,
Hawk.
Yeah, you could build skate parks.
Oh, that was fucking amazing.
That's something they've taken away from games now, isn't it, really? They don't let you build stuff as much.
I'm pretty sure the Far Cry still do it.
Really?
It's the weirdest one.
Oh, they do like community
Far
things,
Cry's.
Don't they? Yeah, they're like, mm-hmm. I think it was like 3, they did it as like an arcade thing, didn't they?
Yeah.
And they've had that since at least the first one.
Oh, shit.
Halo. Yeah, I don't remember the 3 and 4 having it, but I'm pretty sure the latest one might. The one before it, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. Interesting, yeah. Anyway, talking about like, I don't know if on this game you could build your own maps, but they were like pretty crazy maps anyway. But another game on the PS1, so going back to PS1 times, childhood, yeah.
Memory lane this.
But Micro Machines V3 was awesome.
I played this one too.
What a good game, yeah. That was a great game. I never actually owned the game, I don't think. I always went round to friends specifically to play this game.
Didn't even like a friend.
Everyone has those games though, yeah. That was Mario Party.
It was right. Yeah. That was Mario Kart for you.
Yeah. Mario Kart.
GoldenEye.
Yeah, they've even got Rocket League or they've got the Super Wizard, whatever it was that you called it.
Whatever the fucking name
Super
is.
We've got the knockoff version.
Rock Battle Cards, yeah.
The Player 2 controllers, the janky ones that you get as well.
Yeah. Oh, fucking hell. It's been thrown against the wall 10 times. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you can play this one. That's yours.
But this
game doesn't work.
This game was like a masterpiece. Your little cars on like weird shit.
This is the Citizen Kane of video games.
The Citizen Kane of games, yeah. But, yeah, I mean, like, I was watching a video earlier, and you're literally driving around on a pool table. And you're going down the holes and everything.
Genius. It's the science table, I remember.
Yeah, the science table was a good one. Yeah, I remember there's one we're like outside in a muddy like garden, aren't you?
Oh, in the garden, yeah. And when you went over the water, you turned into like a little boat.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
so good.
This game sounds amazing.
I can't. Right. Have you never played it?
I think. I feel like I might have played it in like Toys R Us. Like that's the only like memory I have.
I forgot that you could used to be able to play games in Toys R Us.
They always have one console, didn't they?
Pod Racer were like the two games.
That was like one of the best reasons to go to Toys R Us.
So good, yeah. I played Metroid Prime for the first time in Toys R Us. Toys R Us, man, what a place.
It's coming back. Have you seen it's coming back?
Is it? Yes.
Yeah. It's actually coming back. Maybe they'll have Micro Machines V3 in there.
Like, can I put a request in?
Can I play this? But you can also, there's also like weird characters in the game. And I've got a.
Ride. Let's go.
So whenever you pick your character, they do like a weird, like, right, let's go. Or like a little, like, catchphrase. It was so shitly voiced.
Right, let's go.
It did look like it was made by some.
They look like Play-Doh people. Yeah.
It was not the best.
I don't know why you needed a character. You were in a car, in like a mini car. Why would you need a character? But whatever. Yeah. But that was.
They did
like
that with Driver, though, didn't they? They like had a character model and everything, but you were in the car.
Yeah, that's who's talking. Yeah, those characters. Yeah, it's weird. Every time you'd go on a level, like one of the characters would talk on who is racing. So weird.
Or would it like come up with like a little icon?
So there'd be like multiple icons on the screen, like, and one would like zoom in or one would zoom out, and then they would talk.
Do a barrel roll.
basically that sort of thing. Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of what it sounds
yeah.
like.
Yeah. But I remember it being really slick and like, but I was watching footage of it earlier and it's not slick at all. It's literally like,
no.
You know how like on a car, if you turn, there'd be a little bit of resistance. Literally you turn and you just go right at a right angle.
Yeah. Oh, I'm in the wall. Fuck.
Someone was, oh, I was watching a mental playthrough. They were like professional, I swear, at Micro Machines V3.
Professional,
they were
like, Micro Machines player.
Basically,
yeah, Micro Machines V3 specifically.
It was that, yeah. It was. What a title. They were so good at the game. I was like, I never used to be that good.
Oh my god.
Yeah, probably helped if I'd owned it. I could have played it more, I suppose. But
we actually did own that one.
Oh, very posh. Ooh.
That's all I have. I have no other update. It was fine.
How do you ever hardly ever play?
I looked upon it, but I never played it.
So going
Matt
back,
has
even...
basically named the two racing games that not I owned, but my family has ever owned.
The only ones.
Yeah. It was that, Smuggler's Run, and the Mario Kart ones.
Mario Kart. How is that not been a name? Mario Kart.
That's the next one. That's Mario Kart.
Nintendo, like, fuck, write that down. Write that down.
Yeah. Get that. Yeah.
Crossover. Yes. We've been struggling for years.
We've been wondering what to do with Mario Kart 9 for so long. Oh, jeez. So going on from old games. Mark, you have an older game, don't you?
Yeah, I do. It's probably one of the oldest games I think I've spoken about on here. So
older than
one of my favourite games. One of my favourite games is Outrun, which originally came out in 1986 in the arcade.
Fucking hell. Sorry. Really surprised me.
I mean, it looks like it, so yeah.
Sam is surprised because he didn't realise anything existed before 1992.
Yeah. Like, there's a bunch. What the fuck?
This one's like, it's hard to explain because this is kind of the first game that's inspired so many like it.
Yeah.
And how do you kind of go, oh, this is the first one in the series? So this is a non-linear gameplay, kind of the soundtracks at the start you could choose, which is a brand new thing as well for the arcades. I don't know if you've got a clip you can play.
Which one's this? Outrun? Outrun or Overdrive?
Outrun.
We get like Sonic vibes from this. Is it Sega who make these games?
Yeah, Sega.
Yeah. That's a Sega soundtrack right there. Like, I mean, Green Hill.
So they're pretty simple games. You just pick one of the three songs at the start in the arcade. I think when they remastered it for consoles, I think you can actually play it on Switch now. It's Sega Ages Outrun. And there's six songs you can choose now instead.
Oh, thank fuck. My dream is achieved.
Yeah, pretty simple. You're in a Ferrari Testarossa Spider, and you've got your blonde girlfriend next to you. You're playing your tunes with your roof down. And all you've got to do is just avoid traffic and get to the end. That's it.
That's the life, mate. That's the life.
But this game just had so much influence on kind of everything that came after it. Even the music from it was inspired. So you've got Synthwave, but another name for Synthwave is actually Outrun.
No way. Oh my god.
So it's kind of the whole franchise.
Oh shit, it is, yeah. I love Synthwave.
Is it?
Yeah.
Synthwave is such good.
Is it? Is it? So any games that kind of do the same as Outrun and then add the Synthwave soundtrack over the top, I'm a sucker for it. So there is one I've been playing at the moment called 80s Overdrive. So it's got like 19 Synthwave tracks, and it's got kind of that neon-esque kind of grain over the top.
Yeah.
And it's a bit more updated as well, so you can actually see the turns before they come up. Whereas in the original Outrun, you're pretty much on the fucking corner before it loads in, and you've just got to whip it.
But renders.
That's fine, they did the 90-degree turns.
Yeah. And then, you end up flipping the car most of the time. Your blonde girlfriend's out of it, you're out of it.
She did.
I'm sure this will come up on future podcasts, but I really struggle with like retro games. I really struggle going back to old games, especially like.
See, I really like retro games. I think that's
I know
where
you do.
We
yeah,
sometime.
I think as we've discussed, the PS1 era is hard to go back to. I like SNES and. NES.
See, I don't like that at all. I'd rather go back to PS1 stuff.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know what it is. I just hate
I'm
that
kind
pixel
of...
art.
I'm kind of in the middle because I'm willing to go back for certain things. Yeah. But every time I do, I kind of hate myself and regret it.
But would you go back to a Metal Gear game instead of a Metal Gear Solid game?
Maybe, yeah. If I felt like, if they were like necessary to the story, I probably would. But I feel like they're not. So,
some might argue they are.
they could be, but I wouldn't know.
Oh, what, the first two, do you mean?
Like, yeah, the old ones. Like 2D ones.
Proper Metal Gear ones, yeah.
Just read the wiki page. So can...
See, you've got to fucking know the story.
Just ask Sam, he'll tell you.
Yeah. Well, last time, he directed me to a video that didn't exist.
Here you go. Nothing.
I don't know what to give you, so...
Yeah, I think Outrun 2 is came out in 2003, and that kind of went crazy with like the drifting you could do in that. So that's the one you probably saw the most in the arcade, where you could just really just whip the wheel round and drift around the corners.
You've never been to an arcade?
Not like an 80s arcade that I'm...
What are you? Oh, no, yeah.
I never went to an 80s arcade either. Like... I wasn't fucking born yet.
What kind of arcade is there?
There was one in the corner. Milton Keynes, where you used to go bowling, there was also an arcade there for years and years.
Mate.
When it used to be downstairs.
Go to Felixstowe in Suffolk and you'll have
Great Yarmouth. Why the fuck would you go to Felixstowe?
It's the biggest port in Britain, Matt.
It's not the biggest
fucking arcade place, is it?
They might have like a couple of machines, but I've never seen like a proper arcade like I'm picturing.
For me, it's like House of the Dead was one I always used to play. Time Crisis.
I loved
both of those, and then I'd go and play the racing games. I think we very recently had some when we went to London. We did the Mario Kart racing.
That kicked your ass. Yeah, I remember.
That's the part he remembers, for fuck's sake.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was an arcade. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I just love this. I think 80s Overdrive has managed to kind of beat out Outrun a little bit. I had to talk about Outrun because it's what started it all. But 80s Overdrive with the synth wave and the style. Yeah, for me, it's the game I kind of go back
Outrun?
To a lot.
Is Outrun like a mobile game now? Like
they probably
been, like
it
rebranded.
To mobile.
Yeah, I feel like I've seen that on an app store somewhere.
I think there's a lot of ones that use similar names.
Yeah, Outrun, Overdrive, Overrun.
Wasn't there
Outdrive?
Is there an Outrun on the Dreamcast? There must have been, right.
Yeah, so the ones on the Dreamcast were two, and then they had Coast to Coast was the other one.
Yeah, I think I played Coast to Coast. That rings.
And Coast to Coast is the weird one. Because it's like really cheap on all the consoles apart from Xbox. It's like 80
quid.
You
played the weird one, Sam.
I feel weird.
It's like stupidly expensive. I'm like, why? Why is it so expensive for this one? Just on the Xbox.
Oh, man.
Yeah, we're talking about the 80s Overdrive. Could you play the other sound clip I sent you?
Run this for 3 minutes.
I like this one.
This is another 3 minutes.
So good, man.
It's so good.
It hits the spot.
So that game is just literally 18 tracks like this.
If you,
I'm buying this game off this podcast.
If you like that sort of music, have you ever listened to Kavinsky?
Kavinsky's Outrun album as well.
Really?
It was kind of, yeah.
Because he did Nightcall. Right?
That's why I knew the name Outrun then. Yeah, Nightcall.
Yeah, Nightcall is such a fucking good track. Yeah. Oh my god.
But the music is very that.
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, it's very
he's
much.
Got a new, he's got a new. He's got some new music coming out.
Oh, yeah, Drive.
Oh, yeah, Drive's a good film. I don't mind driving films. They're okay.
Yeah, you love Fast and Furious, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
And then there you go. Going on there to special mention from my favourite. So kind of keeping with the arcade-y theme. Burnout 3 Takedown is the special mention I wanted to bring up. Yes. Mainly because, obviously, the race mode, fantastic, but the crash mode. Oh,
so good.
I'm not entirely certain I've ever played the race mode of this game.
I don't think the race mode.
You still take down people, don't you? You still take down people in the race mode,
right?
Yeah, that's what's so satisfying. So you're just driving to obviously a destination, but you're trying to like sideswipe them out and hit them off the barriers.
Yeah,
so good. Yeah, it goes into slow mo.
Did Burnout 3 come out for the PSP? There was definitely a Burnout game. Was it 3 or was it just like a spin-off game?
I think it was Burnout Revenge.
Yeah, that rings a bell. So, oh my god, when me and my friend, this was like in year 10 or 11, maths class, and we were just at the back of the class on separate desks, and we were just like, should we play Burnout during this class?
Get away with that one.
Well, we didn't really in the end, because we started the race and my friend crashed like straight away, and I was in fucking tears, like literally. He was like left behind me, and he got set out of the class. The teacher was like, "All right, get out. You need to go calm down." Oh, it's fucking such a fucking good memory.
I definitely thought you were going to say you left the sound on.
That's what I thought he was going to say. It was like, yeah.
Just full blast.
It's just the instant crash just killed me.
And that driver.
It's just, I don't know what it is about the Burnout franchise as a whole. It's so satisfying. Paradise was really good, but they did have that weird ass release with it. Like, there was two versions of Paradise. One had multiplayer and the other one didn't.
Yeah.
But it wasn't ever clear when they sold it.
Paradise means different things to different people.
You're the fucking worst. I hate you.
I have nothing else to contribute.
Just want to see what else out of the sink and chuck it.
Yeah, because Burnout 3 as well was the first one to do impact time. So when you did crash, you could then move your vehicle. So when you'd have the explosions,
you could
kind of go in slow-mo and get all the multipliers.
I don't remember. I don't. Burnout Paradise wasn't as good for me. Definitely not. It was just a bit duller, I thought, even though it was like open world. Kind of because it was open world, I think it kind of like ruined it a bit. Because Burnout 3 wasn't open world, was it?
That was the last one in the franchise, wasn't it? They've not really, apart from the remaster, they've not done anything since.
No, I mean, I don't know. I think it did all right, but I just don't. Personally, for me, I thought it was a bit boring. It just wasn't that fun.
Yeah, I think I gave it a go, but it was definitely like Burnout 3 was the.
It's the one.
I feel like they need to bring back the crash mode. Just as a separate game. Like, that needs to be just a game on Xbox somewhere.
There's not many
the crash modes.
There's not many games like that. Like, there's, for me, on the PS1, there's something called Destruction Derby, which is obviously what it is. It's what it is on title, you know, it's cars smashing into each other and you've got to take out all the other cars, eliminate all the other cars, basically. That was fantastic at the time. And that kind of, like, that was great that they brought it into, like, racing games with Burnout. And then there's one recently called Wreckfest, which is basically Destruction Derby in the modern era. But, I don't know. They just don't seem to do that many games with that sort of element anymore. Like, I think Need for Speed Hot Pursuit had it a bit, didn't it?
Yeah, that's what I've been. I've been enjoying it so much, playing it on Switch. It just gives me that kind of vibe.
There's Burnout 3 vibes, which is nice. But, I just feel like there should be more games like that. Crash.
Yeah,
that's what people want to see.
And that is it. We hope you enjoyed listening to our Tepid Take.
If you want to send us your Tepid Takes, then email us at thetepidtake@outlook.com.
And give us a follow and a like on Instagram at thetepidtake.
And we've been the fucking, what's it called again? What a car crash of an episode.
Yeah, put that after.
That's for you, Sam.
Thanks, Addison.
Ka-chow!